Hello, good morning everybody. Thank you for being here. This is Giancarlo Ferraro and we thank you for your presence here today to this second webinar that we set it up for our customers. Today we're gonna introduce you to the Hyper Concrete Polishing System. It will be a pretty, say, long demo, so we will try to be as clear as possible, but also we will try to do not go as longer as we expect. So this webinar will last probably a couple of hours, so 2 hours and a half, 3 hours maybe, okay, depending on the setup and also about questions, okay? So we are going to wait for other 5 minutes and see how many of other people will join us, okay? And after that, we are going to start the demo. As I was saying, today we are going to a demo and to do a webinar and to introduce to many of you that don't that are first approaching to our company of our Hyper Concrete system. The Hyper Concrete system is a polishing system for concrete and hard surfaces, also for terrazzo in some cases, and other surfaces that are related to the concrete. Now, it's very important to say that this type of polishing system can be matched to a very large variety of concrete. So for soft concrete, medium hard, very hard concrete. It can be involved in this system. It can be involved also repair of cracks and any type of damages created on the surface by a long use or because we are providing and we are making this system on a old concrete that need a reparation, okay? So, as I said, we are going to wait another five minutes, really, and then we are going to start. We would like to thank you again. It's very important for us, and this is very important, that if you can please provide us your presence by send us an email to our email address, providing us some information about your company, your name, your location, okay? So for each of you, I would like to really thank you if you could send us an email at info@hypergrinder.com, so info@hypergrinder.com, and so we know your presence, we will keep you informed on our products, on our systems, day by day, weekly basis, email mailing, okay? So if you could please send us a brief presentation of your company for those that, at least for those that are just approaching to us. So info@hypergrinder.com. So please, a few minutes and we are going to start. Siamo pronti, raga? Okay, so I would like to introduce you a little bit for the equipment that we are going to use. I'm not going to go into the details of the equipment, but it's very important for us to give you some information about, at least about the equipment. Then we're gonna go on the polishing system. So we are going to provide you the webinar today with the Titan 750. The Titan 750, it's in this case, is a manual version grinder. It's also available in RX and Autopilot. For those that know our company, we are the only one providing the Autopilot system on RX remote control grinders. It's a gear-driven planetary polisher and grinder. It's this type of this type of planetary is our top of the line planetary. It's the most advanced. It's made of stainless steel gears, three heads, 240 millimeter, 9.5 inches each. The weight of this unit is approximate of 650 kilos. Okay, pretty heavy. As I say, it's a manual model, three-phase, 400 volts. Together with the Titan 750, we are going to support the unit with a DAX collection vacuum. This is the HyperVac 777. In this case, is a three-phase model for the European market. It's also available in 220 for the American market, 220 single and three-phase, with a 4 kW turbine, cyclone, and side pre-separator. Okay, it's a automatic self-cleaning. It's semi-automatic self-cleaning. It means that it's capable to clean the filter itself, 3-cylinder filter and 1 HEPA filter for the motor and for the turbine. Okay, so a pretty good vacuum for heavy duty application, for grinding, coating removal, and for only for polishing. Okay, so let's go ahead with the polishing system. As you can see, we are now, today we are demoing on a pretty new concrete. So this was poured not more than 1 month ago. So it's a pretty new. The PSI, the range of PSI is between the 4,500 and 5,000 PSI. It's very hard, it's been troweled. Of course, we are still on top of the quartz. As you can see, we can see some small aggregates of the quartz because we have done some tests before doing this webinar. So it's a pretty hard concrete in a good shape, very new. It's a easy concrete to polish. Now, why I'm talking to you about the concrete? Because as I was telling you, the HyperConcrete system is capable to providing you a very good finishing also on old concrete. Today we are providing a webinar. We are not going to show you any type of reparation or repair on cracks or damages, but we are going to provide you the fastest way to grind and polish with the 5 or 6 or 7 step grinding and polishing system as HyperConcrete. What we have done prior to the webinar, we have made a 30 and 60 grit metal bond diamond, and then now to make it shorter and not to go further than because of the time, we are going to provide last step grinding with 120 grit, very soft, extra soft bond diamond for hard surfaces. Okay, so we're going to finish the grinding process. Then we're going to go on a 60 grit resin bond diamond to remove the scratches. Okay, to remove scratches and to start the honing process. Usually this is the most important step during our polishing system. It's the one that allow you to go from a rough surface to a more smooth surface. Our suggestion in our HyperConcrete system is to provide this step, so the 60 grit wet. Working with this resin bond and water, so wet, it will faster the scratch removal, and so that door that takes you from a grinding and honing process. Now, since today we are doing a webinar on in a pretty good condition concrete, we are going to skip the water and we are going to do it semi-wet. So we are going to use a concrete filler together with the 60 that usually goes with the 120 grit. So that's going to be a 60 grit, a 120 grit, and 220 grit. Usually, we use concrete filler with the 120 grit in this step, okay? So just after the 60. Today, to make it simple, and because the concrete allow us to do it, because it's a pretty good concrete in a good condition, not many cracks and not many, not cracks at all, but not even porosity, a lot of porosity, we are going to provide the concrete filler together with the 60 grit without using water. We will just spray the concrete filler in front of the grinder. What is a concrete filler? Concrete filler is a product that provides you a filling of micro pinholes. Okay, it's a nanotechnology product. It's like a small grouting, a very easy grouting of the surface that you can provide with the grinder. Okay, it doesn't require any type of special machine. You can use it while you are polishing or honing with a resin bond disc. You can spray the product in front of the grinder and make a small paste to cover and to mostly to fill the pinholes that you will have on the surface after the grinding process. So, in our system, usually we provide the concrete filler with the 120, so we use the concrete filler with 120, but today I'm going to make an exception. I'm going to try this 60 grit with the concrete filler. So then after we are going to go with the 120 and then the 220. Now, after the 220, we will clean the surface very well and we will dye the concrete with our concrete color dye. This is a dark blue, is a color that I truly like. It's a color that I'm sure that you will like because it's a very deep tone, it's a nice color, it's very clean after the polishing process. After that, we are going to cover the dye with the concrete hardener, our concrete hardener lithium. It's a concrete densifier, but also on this type of surfaces. And in this case, for the concrete color dye, it will help the color dye not to fade and not to vanish after the application when we are going to proceed with the step with the 400 grit and then after with the 800 grit for the maximum mechanical polishing. After that, we are going to apply our concrete guard lithium WP2. This is a pretty new product, and we are going to show you how this product will retain waterproof, oilproof, and a very low filming product that really provide protection to your concrete floors. Okay, I will talk about this later instead of talking about it now and then after. So we will make also some oil and water test after the application. After we have applied our concrete guard lithium, we are going to buff the surface on high speed with our Discolux for high speed burnishing. Okay, so we are ready to go. With me today is my colleague. That's my colleague that will help me to make the best of the webinar. Okay, so we are ready to go. We are going to put our metal bone tools on the grinder. In the meantime, I'm going to remove this from the surface. It's very important. I would like to remark this. It's very important that you know that during this demo, we will obviously we will give you the opportunity to make us some questions. Now, since the time is we want to keep you busy as less as possible, but we want to be clear and we want to give you, of course, we want to give you the opportunity to debate with us and to make some questions, because I'm sure you will have many questions. We will give you the opportunity to make us some questions and ask for to clarify your doubt during the into time of the webinar. So just after the DAI application, we will stop because we will need to wait the color to dry and also the hardener that we will spray on top to dry. Okay, so we will have a 15 minute time frame to chat a little bit, to talk and to discuss. Then after that, we will proceed with the 400, 800 grit. We will apply the guard. And then after, prior to buff the guard for the final polishing, we will chat a little bit. Okay, then we will gonna make a nice test. I would like to show you, I'm really proud to show you something very new and very, very important during and for the final polishing. Okay, so after the color dye and after the guard, we will have some time to chat and to clarify a little bit about the process. So if you have questions, please write down some question and then I will be very happy to reply to it. Okay. So we are ready. We have setted up the grinder. Okay. The grinder is ready. We are going to put some extra weight on front. The Titan 750 also have sides weight that you can tilt from on the side of the unit. And so to give more pressure to the grinder while operating. Okay. So we're ready. So we're going to go for an area, a pretty large area for a demo. So we are going to go for a 5 meter by 2 meters, and then we are going to make it a little bit smaller step by step. Okay, bye. Bye. Vai avanti e fai il 50% senza tornare indietro. Ok, fai questa e questa, e poi ci fermiamo. Fammi la tuli e ci fermiamo. Aspira. I would like to remark the scratch pattern. This was the first. This was the previous scratch pattern, but this is the 120. Okay, it's a very fine. It's very very fine. As I say, this concrete allowed us to make it easy, to make it very easy. Now after a 120 grit metal, it could be this the time in a real life scenario. Where you have cracks to repair, to clean, reopen, to clean and fill, or you maybe have other type of damages to repair. This is the real time to do repair. So with any type of product, a two component base product or mortar or for example for any type of product for do repair. Okay, so now is the time to clean the surface, apply the product or the repair product for the repair, and then obviously accordingly to the time of curing of the repair product, you go ahead and you wait the time that is needed, and then after that you can start again to start your honing process, same as we are going to do. As I was telling you, now we are going to clean the surface. Now my colleague is changing toolings. He will clean the surface, removing the debris and the dust. And then after that, we are going to proceed with the 60 grit resin. As I was telling you, the 60 grit resin is the only step that in our process is made wet. Okay. Now, if you have, depending on the obviously on the concrete surface and on the scenario that you are facing during the job and to the decision to make, you can. Use the 60 grit of hyper concrete system, wet or dry. Okay, I'm comfortable with both, usually, but also concrete has to help me on this. So it depends, as I say, on the concrete. Okay, usually the wet system help you to be fast in the production. So it help you to at least for the scratches to be removed, to be faster, because as you know in this field it's truly important to be really fast, to get in a job site and get out as fast as possible. Okay, so doing a 60 grit resin, first step resin with water, so wet, it will definitely gives you more production and helps you a lot and more faster to remove the scratch. Today, and since, as I say, this concrete really allow us to do it, we are going to use it semi-wet. What it means semi-wet? It means that we are going to use the resin wet, but we are going to apply the product that I was showing you before. Okay, la vuoi montare? The concrete filler. So we are going to use concrete filler together with the resin, with no water. We will just spray the product in front of the grinder. We will make a small amount, a very tiny, tiny amount of dust, dust mixed with the product, and so that will be a paste that will be messaged to the on the surface, and it will dry. Okay, the application is this. Now I'll show you the application, but it's very important because this product work when it's applied it in the right way. Okay, not fancy things, just spray a small amount of product in front of the grinder before to pass on it. Okay, and let the product get dry while you're doing the friction with the grinder. Okay, it's very important. Product has to dry together with the grinder. You don't have to use, you don't have to leave, it's very important not to leave residue on the surface of the product. Otherwise it will get hard and it will get a little bit difficult with the 120 grit, so the step after to be removed. So a small amount of product just to massage the floor, okay, and the surface. Remember that this product is suitable for micro pinholes, so for very, very, very small holes. That in this case, only in this case, we may have, okay? Some of our product and most of our product during the hyper concrete demos that we do every day with our customers that are coming to visit us are made especially just for showing purposes. It doesn't mean that you have to use this product or any other of the product that we are providing you in the system, but they are suggested in certain situation. Okay, maybe I make you an example. On another type of floor, on another scenario or real life scenario, this product will may not work as we suggest. So maybe on another job site you may need another repair product. We don't need to repair this floor. It's a pretty new floor. We will not do a repair demo. Okay, for the next webinar, maybe we are thinking also to make a webinar with repair involved before the polishing process. So now we go ahead with the 60 grit and puoi togliere l'aspiratore, lo puoi togliere. Sì. We are going to go I'm using a low pressure sprayer. I'm not using anything fancy. Normal low pressure sprayer that usually we use for any type of liquids or chemical involved in the process. That's a type of tool, this is a standard type of tool for us for demo. Usually on in a real life scenario you can use other type, larger type of containment product and sprayers. Okay, this is a standard low pressure sprayer. Okay, so as I was telling you, we are going to spray. I will going to spray the product in front of the grinder, okay, and then before to pass on the second line of grinding, we are going to be sure we have to be sure that the product dried. Okay, so it's truly also important the amount of product that you put on the surface. You don't need, as I said, you don't really need as much. You need the right quantity to provide a floor coverage. Okay. dopo questo devi aspirare bene a terra, prima non hai aspirato. Dobbiamo passare un'altra volta, ma gliela passo io. Allora, faccio la faccia io. So since we have used the sixth grip dry, as I was telling you, I'm doing also a cross pass, because for me right now it's very important to be sure that the scratches from the metal bond are completely gone. The sixth grip resin really allow you to be sure to have a surface free of scratches. Okay, so this is definitely the pass or the step where you really want to stay a little bit more on the surface and maybe to cross in certain cases. This, as I was telling you, this resin bond, 60 grit, will allow you to really be sure that the floor is free of any scratches, that you don't really want to bring with you up to 800 grit, okay? So we really suggest you to work the surface a little bit more before to pass further to the 120 grit, okay? Even because we have used the 60 grit dry and not wet, okay? In certain circumstances, you really want to avoid to use water, okay? So as you can see, another good thing of our hybrid concrete system is that it can be used in very different ways. There's not only one way to use it, but you really can make it as you prefer for the job site that you are facing. Okay. So it's very versatile. It's a concrete polishing system, very versatile, that can be modified depending on the job site. And that's very important, because as many of you know, not every job site is the same. There's many variants, many things that will make things different. Many things. Aspiriamo tutto, aspira tutto. Okay. So now we are going to clean everything. We're going to vac up everything. Okay. Now I'm sorry you cannot touch the floor, but believe me, it's very smooth. And at the touch, it followed the as my experience how the floor has to be after the 60 grit. Okay, very smooth. Okay, it has already turned to a smooth surface. Okay, so we are on the right track. Okay, so this is gonna be a very nice floor. For me, it's very important, the 60 grit, and for anybody that are in this field, it's very important to have a 60 grit. A very well-made 60 grit. I call the 60 grit the door between a job done in the best way and a job that it could be a little bit tricky at the end. But if you really do a 60 grit, I'm talking about hyper concrete, but usually. In any type of polishing system, if you provide a 60 grit, a very very well made 60 grit, you will be in the middle, let's say 50-50 of the job. So it's very important. This is a door between a very well made job and a job with some mistakes or scratches. Okay. So it's better to stay on the floor for a little bit more with the 60 grit instead of go fast. This is the key step on a job site. Now we are going to back the floor, remove the debris, and then we are going to proceed with the 120 resin. Okay? After the 120, we will move further to the 220. And we will prep the floor for this demo to dye the surface, okay? And that will be an interesting point for some of you that use different type of coloration, or probably for most some of you that are just watching this demo for the first time and are not in the concrete polishing field yet, but they want to learn more about it. Okay. Okay. So now that we're done with the 60 grit, we are ready. So this was the 60 grit. Now we are ready to move forward with the 120 grit. Okay? This is the 60, this is the 60, and this is the 120. Okay? And so we are ready. As you see, we use a Velcro system to attach as many as you know to attach the pucks. Okay, so still dry system. Okay, we still use a dry procedure, and we will follow with the next step. 120 grit. Dry. Okay, ahí la doy. So the speed, also the motion speed of the body could be a little faster. Okay? This Titan 750 also have a speedometer. You can reach up to 3000 RPM during the honing process. So with the 60 and 120 grit resin, I stayed between the 800-900 RPM. It's very important. And then I raise up the speed on each step that I do. So for the next step I will add the speed of at least the 10%. Usually this the 60, 120 and 220 that basically are the honing steps usually are is suggested to cross. So it is suggested to do one pass as I'm doing it right now and then maybe to cross, but it's as many of you know, on most of the hard surfaces and with the right system, it's pretty simple to reach a good mechanical shine without crossing. But it is suggested, it's really suggested. It gives you a more refined mechanical shine, and you know, it helps you to be sure that you will reach the desired shine, mechanical shine at the end. So for sure, two passes is better than one. Ok, adesso dobbiamo togliere un po' di polvere. Ok, so now the now that we have done with the 120, we just do the tooling change and we proceed with the 220. Ok, once the 220 will be accomplished and finished, we will clean the floor, ok, to welcome the color dye. So just the time to change the tools and to start again the procedure with the 220. And then we are ready for the concrete color dye. Of course, what we are doing is to change toolings very frequently, okay? So the procedure may be a little, it could appear like a very long procedure. Usually on a job site you don't change toolings that often, okay? So you change tooling only when you have really finished. We are doing a small area, so we change tool very, very frequently. But it's just, I'm telling you this just because of a purpose of not to scare you on how long could be the system. As I said, we are changing tools very frequently because we are doing a patch, an area, a very small area of 5 meters by 4, 3.5, okay? So that's basically what we do in a demo. So we change tooling very frequently because the demo area is very small. In a real life scenario, usually you change toolings only when you have finished the total area, okay? So I think we are ready to start again with the 220. Okay. 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 Mettiamo gli aspiratori. Perfect. So now, just after this, we are ready to go ahead and to provide the first stop. So when you stop on a job site to apply dye, usually on a real life scenario website, this is the time where you stop, you start doing cleaning, you start to set up the surface for the color dye. We are on a 220 grit. Usually in our system is the best time for to apply the color dye. As you see, the surface is free of scratches at all. So we made a good 60 grit resin. And it's very important now to have as much as clean surface as possible. The debris will definitely make things different if you leave the debris on the floor before to applying the color. So we really want to clean very well, okay? Usually auto scrubber with green abrasive pad is the best solution. Clean the floor. I usually suggest it after each step. Between a step and the other, it's very important to remove debris from the surface, dust, debris, or whatever it is. It's very important to clean as much as possible. As much you clean a surface while you're doing a polishing application, a polishing system, as much will be clean, better gonna be the end of the job. So very, very important. It's one of the key of finishing a good job, okay? Okay, bye. Another very important thing is to wait, obviously, after that, if you're using water, it is to wait to get dry, because the color dye, it's mixed with acetone, so it's an acetone-based product. We offer, usually, acetone-based or water-based. The most required, obviously, are the acetone-based, okay? Of course, first of all, for the penetration, okay, because with acetone, the color definitely penetrate more in the surface, okay? And the how last can stay a color, a dye on the surface with acetone base. Okay. Of course, there's some limitation on some job sites that do not allow to use acetone or any alcohol or any alcoholic based product. So it's very important to have a different solution. Another important thing is that usually, if your customer will ever ask you for outside application of concrete color dye, we don't really suggest it because of the UV, because the external agent, natural agent, like such rain, sun, or salt. Maybe sometimes application has to be done on a seaside, so it's not really required and suggested. Sorry. So the concrete color dye is a perfect product for inside application. Another important thing, we have and we can offer you a color table, a color chart, very, very, very wide. Okay, so as many colors as possible. Sometimes it happens, of course, that we have also provided colors in for a specific RAL. Okay, so okay. Let's go ahead. Now, we are ready to color the surface. We're gonna make a mask, okay? So we're gonna make a square with tape. What we use usually for to do masks is standard packaging tape. Also this in summer or in winter is it's suggested to use it when it's not very hot, because the glue on the the glue on the tape, it could melt and be left on the floor. So in the summer season, we suggest you to use some tape that is that has cardboard, paper made base like a 3M 3M tape, blue tape. Okay, so here it is. We made a three layer of tape because we don't want to go outside of the of this mask. Obviously you do these masks when you do demos or in case you have a certain type of logo to make, or you have to make a limitation of area, for example around columns or in any corners or the edges of a job site. Okay, so as you can see, I'm still using a low pressure sprayer. The mix of the color, let me show you how we supply the color. The mix of the color, so we supply color in this quantity. Okay, it's 250 ml that can be diluted in 1 gallon of acetone, 4 liters of gas acetone. Okay, obviously this color can be, in this case we are using a dark blue, which is already very dark as a blue. It's a nice tone, I really like it, as I said before. In case you want to have, I make you an example for the colors that are more lighter, like a green, like a yellow, like any color that are not very strong, okay? The application can be done twice, okay? Or you can reduce the quantity of acetone. Obviously, also the coverage will be reduced, but to have a more strong, a more deep tone. So reduce the quantity of acetone in the mix and you will have a more strong color, okay? Another important thing is what we usually do. Why I'm using a concrete color dye and then after I'm going to densify. I'm doing it for two reasons. First of all, because the concrete hardener helps the color not to fade and to stay as much as possible on the surface. When concrete color dye, when the color dye is dry, usually, and you go after with the 400 grit resin pad, you will lose a small amount of color from the surface. So to reduce the this thing, so to reduce the loss of color from the surface, we use a concrete hardener. The concrete hardener, first of all, yes, it will definitely keep the color pigments on the surface, but it will also do its job. So basically, it will also harden the floor. So a double purpose. Usually, has been done in the past, I've done it in the past, usually you can also use concrete hardener below the color. So you can do a concrete hardener, then you can apply the color, and then you can apply the hardener again. So to prevent also the abrasion from underneath, from any agent like dust and whatever. So, but usually do this application like as I'm doing it right now is for me the perfect way to keep the color as you expect. Okay, so low pressure sprayer, as I've done before, and then I'm going to spray evenly on the surface. Perfetto. Now, this is the first time that this sprayer is used, and so it's a little bit tricky to have it work. Ecco. So this is the best, like a nebulizer, you know? You don't really need to put as much, as many. You want to really make the application without dropping and without using more than more color than the necessary. So you want to go over the surface evenly. The coverage for 1 liter of color could be more or less of 40-50 square meter for 1 liter, okay? Then, as I was telling you, depending also on how the color is deep, you can have more or less coverage, and you can regulate yourself by the dilution, okay? So you want a more deep or more light color. Another thing is very important, and I want to remark, is that the surface has to be really, really, really clean when you do such application, okay? Now we are ready to wait the product to get dry. It will take an approximate of 15 and 20 minutes. Once the color is dried, we are going to apply the concrete hardener. In the same way I've done it with the color, I will do it with the concrete hardener. So then we will wait a little bit more, and then we will go on with the polishing. Okay. So I think now it's time for us to chat a little. So if you have questions, we can start talking a little bit, and you know, at least know each other, because since we have started, we haven't made any presentation. Okay. So if you have questions, right now is the right time to make it. Okay. Posso vedere chi c'è? Ok. So it's also Ibrahim, I think from Jordan. Right, Ibrahim? Aniel Larragnaga. Ok, I see you. Ok, here it is. Not many of you with the cam. Okay, if you have a cam, that will be amazing. Hello, Ibrahim, how you doing?
Hi.
How you doing, my friend?
Hi, Carlo. Thank you so much for this presentation. It's very, very important to communicate with you every now and then. I have a question, please.
Yes.
What's the difference between K10, K30, hardener and lithium hardener?
Okay, obviously there's a concentration between the three, four products we have. We have a very large, as you know, we have a very large range of concrete hardener, okay? There's some of them that have more or less concentration of lithium inside, okay? Also, you're probably asking yourself why we have such many different type of hardener. So most of the time because the dilution. First of all, for the quality of hardener, because not all, since you know that we distribute all over the world, we have different type of customer to cover and market to cover. So there's some market that require a lower cost product or for some other, for example, for the lithium, we are on a good price for the market. So, first of all, for the type of market. Secondly, for transport purposes. Why transport purposes? Because I make you an example. We have now you are in Jordan. You are not so far, okay? But I believe that you do shipping also by sea to reduce the cost. So some of these hardener are more concentrated because of transport purposes. Okay, I prefer to by 1,000 liter, 2,000 liter of Ardener concentrate, because then I can dilute it up to 1, up to 2, up to 3. Okay, so it's also the matter of dilution.
Yes.
Okay, so then we have a certain type of Ardener, like for example the concrete Ardener lithium, that have a very high concentration of lithium, and the quality of the Ardener is way higher. Okay, so that's the reason why we have 3 or 4 different types. Okay, also, I also, you know, you are a long time customer, so you know what I'm talking about. For those that want more information about the product, I also suggest you to inquire us by email, having MSDS, DS sheets, and see also the information of the label and the product itself. Okay. It that was clear enough, Ibrahim?
Yes, thank you so much.
No problem. You have other questions? There's anybody else that has other questions? I don't see many cam switched. So if you have cam, you can switch it. So we can definitely meet up and at least meet to know who I'm speaking with, because it's very important. Not because I want to see you in your pajamas, eh? Or in your house things. I just because, you know, to know who, you know, with I'm talking with, you know. Is anybody else that question to do? Okay. I don't see any other question. So, in some part of the floor, the dye has definitely dried, but it will take some more time. Okay, I'm not going to do any other application. So, because one application is enough for this time, even because the color is very deep. Okay, so. It's fading. Today is not really hot. It's not even cold, but it's not really hot. Usually in summertime, when we apply any type of chemical, the floor, the product really dry very fast. In this case, the product it will take a little bit more time to dry. So what I'm going to do is probably to open a little bit the window, so it will help a little bit. So we are going to wait a little bit more. I want to show you the areas where it got dry. So this is the area where the color got dry, and this is the area where the color still need to evaporate. Okay, as I was telling you, this is still fresh. Okay, so as I was telling you, during the summertime, the product dry very fast. Sometimes don't even touch the floor and it dry, okay? So in winter is a little bit more, it require a little bit more time. It's also very important for those that are approaching to the concrete polishing and concrete coloring for the first time, that it's truly important to say that any type of chemical that you're going to use during the process will need a curing time. First curing time, second curing time. The first curing time is the curing time that the product requires to proceed with the next step. Then the DS curing time. So let's say the curing time that the product requires to work 100%. Okay. Usually a concrete hardener has a curing frame time between the 4 and 6 months to reach the maximum hardness. Or for example, I make you an example, our concrete guard lithium WP2 require a few days to really work as expected. At the end of the application, at the end of the demo webinar, we are going to apply the concrete guard WP2. And we will show you that the product work since the first application, okay? But it does not work consistently, same as if you do the test in few months, okay? Obviously, because the product is fresh, the product need to cure, as I was telling you, and the curing time for chemical, as many of you know, are as a window frame. Okay, now let's do this. To short the time, obviously this is not something that you do on a real life or on a job site, because you really want to wait the color to get dry by itself and not to help it. Okay, we are going to do this. I'm going to apply right away the hardener, okay, so shortcut a little bit the time. I'm going to apply the hardener on top of the color dye, and then I'm going to spread it a little bit. Okay, so after that, we will have, since we have to also to wait that the hardener get dry, we are going to apply it on the color right now, and then wait just the concrete hardener to dry. Okay, so now the concrete hardener, shall I? Perfetto. Okay, so the process will be the same. Still. A low pressure sprayer. Okay. Same application as the color. Okay. So really easy. Sì, mamma, dammi la fastendo io, aspetta. Okay, perfect. You really want to. Okay. I suggest you always to make this wet as well, otherwise you're gonna stick on the floor. This will also, at the end of the day, the application made like this with the microfiber, it will also spread better the color, okay? It will give you more consistency in the deepness, you will spread it more, and it will cover better. Okay, questo lo metto là va. Okay, so. As I was telling you, we have some time now to wait for the product that get dry. Now we have shortcut a little bit, but definitely going to remove the mask also, because after that we are ready to remove the mask. Okay, fantastico. Okay. That at the end of the demo, this will be a nice dark blue. So, if any of you have question, I would really like to answer. Or let's make some presentation if you want. If you have a microphone and you can reply to my question, I do a question to you, and then maybe you do a question to me. Peter is with us again. Thank you very much, Peter. Peter from Hungary, Clindex Hungary. I see also that there's a couple of people. Hello, Peter, how are you doing? Hello.
Everything is good, and the presentation also is good. Congratulations for you.
Okay. Everything good right there?
Yes, I'm really good.
Very well. Very well. Well, some Maske Makinas. So, Peter from Hungary. Then we have Maske Makinas from José Pérez, Mr. José Pérez.
Hola.
Hola, José, ¿cómo está? How are you doing, Jose? I don't see you. Ok, perfect. Quante persone siamo? 30, ok. We are more than 45. Eh? Oh, 30, no, 30, 30 people, 30 people, ok. Ok, perfect. So, as I say, the product is still dry. We will really need some time. So, I cannot make any belly dancing or something like that. So I would really like to receive some question if you have. Ah, Ibrahim, you want to make a question? Can you hear me? No. Okay.
Who's
hello? Hello?
Hello, sir. How are you?
Very good. Thank you. Very good.
I would like to ask you why we use a complete fill-up, why we try with BRIC 60, or why we not use it before or after the grind with BRIC 60.
Ah, okay. I made so. Usually, I'll tell you this. What's your name? Sorry.
Stefan.
Stefan. Okay. So, when I first started the webinar, I told you that I would make only one grinding step, 120 grit. Why? Because the process usually is very long. When we do a demo, it's very long. It lasts, a demo lasts over 2 hours, 2 hours and 30 minutes. So at least I showed just one diamond, one metal diamond. We made some tests the other day. We started with 60. We even made 30 grit, 30 and 16 grit. So we made a 30, then 60, and then we left the floor with the 60 grit. So when we started with the 60 grit under it. And then we have started then with the 120. I just made it for time purposes. Okay, as I said, shortcut of a couple of steps, it will definitely help to shortcut a little bit the time, even because I know that sometimes customer or attendees want to make some questions. So last time we made a webinar of 3 steps that lasted for 2 hours and 30 minutes. So only for time purposes. Also, I want to tell you this. This is a very easy concrete to do a demo on, okay? So even if the floor was troweled, so a very new concrete, just traveled, I could start with the 120 easily, okay? Even because this one was very well installed. No low spots, no high spots. Some clouds at the beginning, but not that much. But it was a pretty decent installed concrete. So it's in this scenario allow you to show you the product better. Not all the products, but many of our products. Usually a concrete like this allow you to show the standard procedure. Then if you have a different scenario like concrete repair, cracks, grout filling, or whatever any other repair product you need, a concrete that is different from this one. Okay. Perfect. Let me. Do you have any other question? Okay, commercial. I need permission to recording. Okay. It is possible to use Guntis. Okay. It is possible. Abbassa un po'. Non riesco a leggere. Okay, it is possible to use that system with standard single disc machine and vacuum cleaner. It is possible to do everything. Okay, so depending on the type of surface. Now, you can polish a floor with a buffer, 17-inch buffer, maybe with a small planetary. I don't know if we have any. We have the buffer, but I don't think we have also planetary, a buffer planetary. You can do it, but it will definitely, first of all, you see, we have also a single disk buffer with the planetary. Andrea, se ti avvicini facciamo vedere. This is a 17-inch buffer with our chain-driven planetary. Definitely, working just with the buffer, yes, you can reach a certain shine. You can do it. Obviously, depending from the concrete condition, initial condition. If you do it with the concrete planetary grande, so with the single disk machine plus a planetary system that you can remove or attach anytime you need, it will be faster. So the thing is this: weight, rotation, it makes a lot. It makes the most in the polishing. Okay, so if you want to do it with a single disk 17 inch, you will need some time. If you do it with a heavyweight grinder like this, the time of production will increase 100 times. Okay, so it's also a matter of speed and weight. Okay, so that was for to reply the question of one of you. Okay, let's see other question. If you have other question, let's see. Mi abbassi un attimo, se hai ancora altre domande? Ok, grazie Stefano da Macerata. Thank you so much Stefano from Macerata. We will have our colleagues to contact you and give you some information. Thank you so much. So 400 grit, it's already with the machine. So we can start, ok? Ok, so we're ready. Ok. Okay, now, as you see, we passed over the color. The best time also, of course, is to wait the curing time, as I was telling you before. Okay, the color will come out a little bit faded here, but it will come out good anyway. Time of application, time to set up the area are very important. Have a successful coloration and also for the polishing, okay? So the time to wait are always very important. Now we changed the toolings from 400 to 800 because is the next step will be the 800. But before to proceed, we need to clean the surface, okay? As I said, it's very important on each step to provide a good cleaning, okay? Obviously, as I said, we are doing a demo. We are not in a real life job, so we are using toolings that are needed for the demo. For a demo, in the real life, if you use auto scrubber, it will be definitely better and faster. Okay. So another key of a successful application is for sure to use to clean the surface at the end of each step. That's truly, truly important. Okay. Okay. Quest'altro. Okay, a posto. Okay, let's go ahead with the 800 grit. And then after we are ready to apply the guard. Speeded up the machine, high speed, and I really want to go fast, also on the color, I really want to go fast, I can go fast easy. obviously the shine, you can of course you can see the shine is dirty, but it's a good shine. Okay. Obviously, in a demo like this, the result is just amazing. It's very dirt, okay? The vacuum have holded the dust very well, but of course, you know, there's also involved some dirt. Now, now is the time to close the job, okay? So it's really required to have an auto scrubber to clean the surface and to vac the water. So a wet cleaning. Okay, it's very very required. Even because in some of the porosity, if you see the floor, in some of the porosity it has debris and dust. Okay, so you really want to clean it very well for the product that we are going now to apply. The product that we are now going to apply is our concrete guard lithium WP2. Okay? So the WP2, it's a new product. The concrete guard lithium is our standard product, and the WP2 is the upgrade. But it's a really important upgrade, because as far as our customer know, the concrete guard lithium hold liquids and provide a very high protection to the surface. In this case, the WP2, which stands for waterproofing tool, okay, it's way more helpful in terms of protection. So if the customer is looking for protection against wine, oil, water, coffee, so in the food industry, this is what you are looking for to provide a protection to a floor, okay, to a concrete floor. Okay? And it retain the liquids, aggressive liquids such as oil, wine, or for example, lemonade. Okay? Also, it retain also lemonade. It protect the floor also from very acid liquids. Okay? So, If your customer is looking for protection against this type of product, we truly suggest to use the WP2 concrete guard lithium. Okay. So we have vacuumed the floor, and then we are ready just to remove the very last debris, and then we are going to apply the concrete guard lithium WP2. This is this product is not only protecting from liquids, but it's also providing a no slippery, let's say it provides a slippery grade that is way lower of the requirement. Okay, it's creating a little film, but it also protect, and it does not make a filming finish that it look like a plastic. Okay, so a very nice finishing protection and concrete strength, so also provide concrete strength. Okay, increase the strength of concrete. The application of the product will be same as we have done with the other two liquids, so with the concrete hardener, with the concrete filler, and with the concrete color dye, still with a low pressure sprayer. Okay. Vai, 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 vai. Mettimi un po' qua, per favore. Ok, still making the microfiber wet. Ok. We suggest always to use this product. It's very important to apply it and to massage the floor and spread it always in the same direction. It's very, very important. Dall'altra parte. You can, of course, you can apply one or two times, okay? Or the first time, abundant. Depending on the grade of protection that you want to give, you can apply it, as I said, one or two times. So to burnish it, we are going to use in real, as I said, many, many times. So what we are doing here is an application, is a demo, and that's to match our spaces and the time frame to accomplish it. So in the real life scenario, the machine to use for burnish this type of product is for sure a concrete burnisher, a floor burnisher, high speed floor burnisher. Now, since we're going to make it easier, we are going to recreate the same application made with the grinder. So we are not going to use the burnisher, but our Titan 750. Of course, in the low speed, because in low speed and with its weight, this machine can really burnish very fast. Aspettiamo prima. So any one of you has any question again? While we're waiting that the product get dry, does any one of you that has question? Me la metti in un'altra posizione, non posso stare qua. Any one of you has questions? Okay, when we need to achieve, so this is Jose Perez. Okay, when we need to achieve an intense and homogeneous color, can we apply after 60 grit hardener and replicate the color after the 220 and hardener again to achieve more homogeneous? Okay, color and the pavement can more harden, the color is able to penetrate even hardener, is correct. So, okay. The hardener, you can use hardener, Jose, thank you for your question, first of all. And as you know, you can use hardener at any step of the concrete, on the concrete polishing system. You can use it on a 30 grit, 60 grit, 120 grit metal, and then you can use it again on 60, 120, and 220. And that's for the hardener. For the color, we don't suggest to apply it at 60 grit, because the floor is too open, the surface is too open, okay? Porosity is very large, so what you are going to do is just to throw the color in the concrete. It will not really affect that much. So my suggestion is, and probably I don't know if you were intent to say so, my suggestion is to do a 120 grit resin, then apply hardener, then 220 grit, apply color, and then on top of it, to apply the Arner again. So to make one lay of Arner underneath the color that then you're going to apply on top on 220, and then on top of it, as we have done, to apply again Arner. Okay, that's what most of the time when it's needed, customer does. So, but very few, because also because the product costs and time. Okay, so always depending on first concrete and second from the customer, the final user and the one that pays for this. Okay, see, this is if this is what you were talking about, please let me know. Jewish wine, are surface protected by gardelidium? Jewish wine, yes, juice and wine. And I say lemon juice and any type of juice. So the lemon juice is the most strong, okay? It's the most acid base. And that is it, and the product, the WP2 protect the floor from also from the wine. Okay, is anybody else that has question to do? Thank you, Jose. Okay. Anyone else that want to make question?
Ciao, Giancarlo. Can I ask you?
Yes, of course.
I would like to ask about the bed sprayer. Can you use the sprayer also for the beton color dye or no?
Can you use?
For the bed sprayer, but that you showed us for the beton color also, with the battery sprayer.
Okay, the very important thing on this battery sprayer, yes, you can spray any type of liquid. Remember always that for Arner, for Gard, you have no limit to spray and rewash, because every time you do an application of Arner or every time you do an application of Gard with that type of with the battery backpack sprayer, you want to rewash it. And you know why? Because the spray tool will get tired, and then it will not spray as suggested. We have made many demos on that, and for sure, washing after any application, washing the tool with water, so empty it and then spray water just inside for to clean the stick, it will also help. It's different from color, because you mix beton color dye, concrete color dye with the acetone, and that basically is the acetone that will kill all the gums inside the stick. Okay, so it's very important, and this is made very well. It's a very well-made product. I'm talking also about the stick, because in this case, it's the most important. You really want to have all the gums in the stick always washed. So together with washing the stick, you really want to open the sprayer top, the sprayer pin, the front sprayer pin, remove the gums, wash it, okay, and after any application. But remember, the first that will go are the gums. So it will last more than a hand sprayer that I used. For sure, it will last more, but you really want to take care of it, okay?
Okay, about thank you very
much. No problem. Okay, Tony Adrover. Hi, Giancarlo, congrats for your presentation. Tony from Mallorca, beautiful Mallorca. Wanting to know how many hours we have to wait after apply the Arner, after the lithium. Okay, as I was telling thank you, Tony, thank you for your question. As I was telling you, any chemical that we use, acetone base or water base or lithium base, whatever it is, any chemical in the concrete polishing industry, but in general, chemicals always have a curing time. Okay, the first curing time is the one that you asked, so the application. How long you have to wait? Usually, I do overnight. I suggest overnight. So you apply the product before to leave the job site at 5, 6, 7, 8 p.m., depending how many hours you work. And then you carry on working the day after. If you do work overnight, you do the reverse. So if you work during the night, you leave it in the morning at 6 a.m. and then the night, the shift after, you start again. Usually, it's suggested always to have the product to cure as long as possible for a best application and the best result. Okay, so usually 5-6 hours. Okay, but longer it stays, better it's gonna be. Now, it's very important that also there's some variation because there's some also about the dilution, for example, for the hardener. It depends how much you dilute, how good you did it and applied it. So if you apply hardener with the high dilution, it will be easier to remove. Also the excess, you don't want to leave excess, hardener excess, because when hardener excess get hard, it's very hard to remove it, okay? Usually, if well applied, 5-6 hours is the best. Then there's the curing time for the long curing time, so the 4-6 months curing time of the product to work as for the MSDS, okay? Thank you, Tony. Okay, there's any other question from anybody else? Hi, Malik, how you doing? Thank you for being here again.
I'm good, thank you so much. Actually, I'm on the Max Tech. This is a WP2 guard which acquired. Is this can be used as an argument of a scudo type of thing that is highly water repellent?
If you can use hardener, you say hardener water repellent?
No. I want to say that. Scudo, before our last webinar, you told us about the scudo, metal scudo, which is high water repellent and water resistant and non absorbent.
Okay.
The WP2 is alternate of it.
Okay. You were talking about the scudo. Beton scudo.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. This is a total different product.
Yes.
It's total different product. Beton scudo is a great product. I really like it. It's very filming. It's very thick. Okay, when you apply it, it's very thick. You can apply it also. Yeah. You can also apply it prior to this, okay? So you do a beton scudo, then this. We suggest to apply this product only, without any other, product underneath of it, okay? Because this is a nanotechnology, is a product that it cannot make any special reaction with any other product. So we don't really suggest to mix it with other, okay? So one lay of scudo, for example, and another lay of WP2, okay? The difference between the two that has been tested, this one has been tested, WP2 really work also on coffee, on juice, okay, not only on oil, which oil is already a very important protection, because not any sealers work with oil, and old oil, because on the sealer you can apply oil and keep it on for 10 minutes, then you really want to remove it because it's gonna start to penetrate or to destroy the film. On this product, you can really leave it on, okay? You can really leave it overnight, okay? I'm talking about the oil, okay? So this is a product that comes after a long research in nanotechnology and for different type of products, such as coffee, wine, as I said, lemon juice, oil, water, okay? It really, really, really work, okay?
Okay, thank you so much.
No problem, thank you for the question. Any other question? Because we are ready to buff. But I would really love to have some other question, if it's possible, if you have it. Otherwise, we carry on with the buffing and high speed. Okay, perfect. Okay, let's go ahead. So we have set up the Titan 5 750 with the DiscoLux pads, okay? Let me tell you again, the right tool, the right machine to use for buffing high speed is a high speed machine. Nothing better than that. Now, because of a demo purpose, we are going to use the same machine that we use for all the webinar. Okay, it's very important. Also because DiscoLux pad, a 24 or 28 inch DiscoLux pads, it will last more than this with the weight of the grinder. Okay, for us is a matter of to be comfortable without using the high speed machine. So we use the same Velcro. I suggest you also to clean, if you're gonna do same as us, to clean very well the machine shroud, underneath the machine shroud, because as you can see, it's full of dust. So if you are going to use the grinder same as we are going to do, I suggest you to place the unit outside the working area, clean it, and since we have rotation and also we have a lot of speed, so the machine is pretty heavy, we are going to put the speed at the minimum, so very low, because we have either speed and weight, and we are going to go on top of the products very fast. Okay. Okay, it's truly amazing. Very, very well. Very, very well. Now, if you want to do another application, you can keep doing an application. You can keep with another spray and apply again. Okay. Let me open the door, because I really want you to see the reflection. Okay, let's see if we... Niente, si vede? Can you see? A little better? You need some glasses. You really need some glasses. Oh, nice, nice, nice. So as I said, a second application can be done, can be provided, okay, in case customer want some extra protection, longer protection, also depending on the type of use of the floor your customer is going to do for forklift or just foot traffic, whatever. It's very important. One or two applications that's the difference between the two because of the use of the floor, of course, okay? However, the finishing is amazing. I really, really like it. I really, really like this color, which I made also the hyperconcrete video on YouTube with this. And after the video, we started to have a lot of requests for this color, which is very, very nice. Okay. Now, for sure, from the camera you cannot see, but I want to talk about a little bit about some imperfection, but not in the system that much, but in the application of the guard. Okay. As I was telling you, there's some, as I was telling you, the application has to be done with a surface as clean as possible. If you see, there's all these marks. Okay, these marks are made by an incorrect use of the microfiber, which was me. Okay, now the microfiber has to be very, very clean, very wet of product. Okay. And the floor has to be, believe me, 100% free of any dust, because the marks that you see are made by dust and dirt from the floor, and the dust was coming from here. Okay, so what I've done is that I collected dust from here while I was spreading the product, and I take it there. Okay, then with the second pass I made all these marks. So very careful also on, first of all, on the dirt, second on to have a clean job site if you want to finish the job as expected. Okay, just well, this was just a point on something that can happen while you're doing an operation like this. So this can happen to anybody, okay? So it can happen to me, to you, and to anybody. A suggestion, just a small suggestion. So I would like you now, if you have questions, to ask. If you have questions, please let me make the guard. Okay, now we have, okay. How long does the WP2 need to dry? Okay, WP2 need to dry at least the same as any other guard. It depends on the weather, okay? With the cold weather, probably 1 hour, the minimum. In the hot weather, like in Spain or like in Italy, during the summer, 10 minutes. 10 minutes is dried, okay? Not even touching the floor. Is already dry, so that's the time of drying time is the same as our concrete guard lithium, the normal, the standard one. Okay, so that's the same. May the guard lithium may be applied on certain marble types? Absolutely yes, absolutely yes. I have a terrazzo floor in my house. Now terrazzo, it's a mix of stone and concrete. So I have a terrazzo floor in my house. Before of the first lockdown, when it was the time of the first lockdown, I had nothing to do at home. So I brought a levigator at home. I made all the floor of the house. And since in some part there's more traffic, instead of buffing with polish compound and refinishing like a terrazzo, standard way, I used a concrete guard lithium. So yes, also on some, also on marble, you can use it. Okay, you can really use it. Don't, but please don't expect to have the same reflection, the same natural color, the same look, beautiful look of marble after polish or after a standard polishing process, because the concrete guard lithium really change a little bit the appearance of the final finishing, okay? You will see that it's basically, you will see a small, you know, a very thin, thin lay film of product on the surface, okay? Which we all know, at least in Europe, how we do like marble floor to be refinished. But if it's for a technical, if it's for a technical matter, for example, in a restaurant, yes, absolutely, yes. It can be recommended, okay? To use a guard on stone, okay? Made the guard, okay, perfect, perfect. Thank you, Jose, for your, and also on countertop. Yes, absolutely, also on countertop. That's another thing, very important. On countertop for food and, you know, because of food dropping and stuff like that. Also, let me tell you this, you just told me something that, you just remind me something very important, Jose, and this is a very good news that we are coming out with. And it's about this product with an antibacterial certification. This is very important, Jose, and I want to tell to everybody, of course. The concrete guard lithium WP2 will come soon out with a national certification for antibacteria. Okay, so it can be used in the food, but also in the pharmaceutical, for pharmaceutical purposes. Okay, that's very, very important. We will, of course, provide you all the MSDS information for you to study the product and to learn more. Okay, so it is coming something very, very important, something very new. Okay, in this about this type of application, also for food, for the house, for you know, not only for big house or big jobs like pharmaceutical or restaurant or stuff like that. Okay, also for antibacteria for your house. Okay, for to apply on your floor or to apply it on your countertop. Thank you, Jose. You remind me something very important. Okay, there's somebody else that want to make any question. I would really love to reply. Okay. Okay, Ibrahim. Ibrahim Alaskar. Alaskar.
Hello.
Hello, Ibrahim. How are you doing?
Okay. Does the compressive strength of concrete affect on shining? If yes, what is the minimum compressive strength recommendation to polish?
Absolutely, yes. The concrete hardness really help on the shine. Absolutely. Okay. Of course, we don't really want a really hard concrete. I would say compression, I would say from the highest 5,000 PSI down to 3,000 PSI. 3,000 PSI is already kind of a little soft, okay? Also, it's also a matter, geographical matter, okay? If you are on the sea, most of the time, for example, in South America, Central America, all the cities around that basically are built around in an area of sea area, the concrete installation are always very soft because the abundance of sand in the concrete mix. Okay. Also, there's no use of quartz on top in the most of the time. So yes, the final polishing is really, really matter in the terms of hardness. This concrete that we have polished today is very hard, okay? It's really, really hard. It's over the 5,000 PSI. It's very, very hard. Has been quartzed, has been troweled, has been made as we have required it, okay? Because Yes, when it's hard, it's most of the time it's easier to polish. But when you go over the 5,000 psi, sometimes it could be a tricky for certain type, not of polishing tools, but for metal tools. Okay, you really want to find a very soft bone for grinding if you need to grind. If you need to polish after the grinding polishing, more or less you get always the shine that you want. Okay, because you can work with the mechanical shine up to 1500 in case you don't reach the mechanical shine, and then you get help from the concrete guard, because the concrete guard really improve the shine. Okay, it gives protection, but obviously it improve the shine. Also, it helps you if you made some mistake, if you have some heavy scratches or light scratches that you see just after the 800, so it helps you a lot. It look like it work like also a mask. It forgives you, as I say. Okay, it forgives some of your mistakes. Okay, and that's very important. But yes, on a soft concrete, let's say that you need. We stopped at 800. On a soft concrete, you really want to stop at 1500. Because you don't get the desired shine. Then it's also about the composition, it's also about if it's wavy, and there's a lot of variant, a lot of variation, but usually yes, up to a certain hardness, it's more easy to polish a concrete instead of softer, but up to a certain hardness. After that, after the 5,500 psi, you start to be in a little bit in trouble. Any other question? Okay, so Tony. Okay, this new lithium can protect from hydroalcoholic gel. Okay. I don't have made test. I believe yes, but we haven't made test. If you have, we can make test. We can let you know. Hydroalcoholic gel, absolutely. If you have a special brand of a product, but it can hold. It depends also on the grade of alcohol inside this gel. Okay. Gel, the alcohol kill any type of alcohol or acetone or anything that is very alcoholic. It can kill the product, can really destroy the product. So step by step, we will probably arrive to the alcohol or alcoholic products. But we can make a test. There's no problem on that. But I still believe that you can drop it, but you really want to remove it, okay? Because it can have a certain time of reaction and can be way too aggressive on the concrete guard, okay? Okay, Tony, thanks. Any other question, please? Okay, no other question. So, if you don't have other question, I would finish. I would like just to remind you what we have done. We have started with the 120 grit metal, then 60 grit resin dry with concrete with our concrete filler. Then after that, 120, 220 core dye blue, dark blue, concrete color dark blue, and hardener on top. We waited a little bit more, but then we started again with 400, 800, and concrete guard WP2. Okay, and then we burnished. If you want to receive information on our products, you can connect with us. You can send us an email at info@hypergrinder.com, or you can refer to a local distributor. Okay, if you have it. In case not, you can revert direct to us, and we will revert to the local dealer in case we have it. And you can connect on our Definitely on our social media, Facebook, Instagram, and also on Twitter. Okay. I would like to thank you so much again for being here. It's a great pleasure for us in this time to be in touch with you, because unfortunately we cannot, we are not free to travel yet, but and believe me, it's hard for those that travel every month. And I know most of you knows what I'm talking about. So I would like to thank you again. We will inform you for the next webinar. Thank you again, and stay in touch with us, and have a great day. Thank you so much.